Hello YouTube, this is Prometheus 1979-9791. Today is the 1 month review of the sanrenmu 710. It's a Chinese made knife. The company is the makers of some knives that are made by Benchmade and as well as Spyderco, so far as I hear. Correct me if I'm wrong. I guess some of their more affordable overseas knives. I guess that's who makes them. And this is the Bird Flight with G10 handles. Combination edge. Okay. I sharpened this twice through the month that I've had it. I ran it into some concrete, cutting some cardboard. For those of you who don't know, cardboard is one of the worst enemies of a knife. And the reason for that being is that the cardboard is very fibrous, very dense material. Now, I'm sure you can think of different materials that would hurt the edge of a knife far worse than cardboard, one of those being concrete. But as far as materials go that you would cut normally with a knife, cardboard is one of the worst. It dulls knives really well. So, I have sharpened it, not much. I haven't used anything more than a smooth steel, which actually is not sharpening, it's actually honing, because it doesn't take any steel off of it, if you know what you're doing when sharpening with a steel, or honing with a steel. So, and then other than that, I used a 1000 grit Lansky. Otherwise, this is the same edge as I had on it when I got it. It's still cutting good. It's worked great. Mostly what I cut at work is cardboard. You know, my use of a knife. And as you can see, this held a really good edge so far. This is my daughter's homework. Looks like she got a star on it. You can now she doesn't have to worry about the excuse of the dog ate the homework. It's daddy used it for his knives type stuff. So that actually was kind of a weird cut. Kind of ripped down in there. Kind of cut straight down. But there you go. If I can get the right angle, cut the paper on, you can see it cuts it well. This isn't any thicker than fine newsprint. So, you can practically whittle paper with it if you want. And, oh, the wood. Here we go. It's a nice chunk. It's not very thick, really. Although it's decently thick. So let's make another cut. Pardon the camera bump there. It's a pretty nice cut. As you can see, it does hold an edge pretty well. And I think it is a pretty good EDC knife, aside from the lack of length. A couple of things that I have noticed about this knife that I particularly don't care for about it. So for me, it's a 3-finger grip. I prefer 4. You can kind of choke up towards the edge if you want. Get your 4-finger grip on there. But when looking at it in comparison to the Bird Flight G10, there's a big difference in there with the width of the handle. And how skinny it is, it's pretty similar. Probably close to the same, if not the same. But this is a much more contoured handle, and I prefer it. But like I said, this is a three-finger grip for me. If I wrap my pinky around it, I only get around that little protuberance right there. And it doesn't give me any more control. So, the worst parts that I would say is how thin it is and how narrow it is this way. Okay, I'm not going to be carrying this anymore as an EDC, unless just I feel like it sporadically. Decided to change my mind. So, it's a good knife. I'd recommend it. Some people might say I have large hands. I wear about an 11 on my ring finger there. So, that gives you any clue to the length of my fingers or whatever, the size of my hand. I've got my middle finger. The blade's not as long as my middle finger. I'm just trying to give you a size comparison. This is just a little longer than my middle finger. And I honestly prefer this one over this one. So, now, I haven't done much sharpening to this bird. I straightened the edge out. As far as, I've used this thing like crazy for that 2 months that I did the reviews on it. One of the downfalls it has is this one is a partially serrated blade, so doesn't quite dig in as good or have the cutting surface area of a normal plain edge knife. But as you can see, it does cut quite well. And this really is just like the thinnest paper. See, I'm getting nice clean cuts. A pair of scissors would cut that clean, honestly. Got you a feather stick there. Not a lot of featherings, really. And there's a bit thicker of a piece of wood. So let's go ahead and just take a few shaves into it. If you ask me, that is carving beautifully. Got your feathers there. Excuse me. There we go. Cuts quite deep down into it. Let's try another angle over here. Anyway, there you go. There you have it. Bird flight. I've kept this nearby all the while carrying the Sanrenmu 710. And I would have to say that the Sanrenmu 710 has done a pretty good job of cutting all the while that I've had it. You can see this bird flight still doing quite well. Anyway, between these two, I would have to say I would choose the bird flight over this. Aside from, if you are not a fan of the chiseled edge, this is a double-sided edge. This might be what you'd like to go for, but remember there's the lack of grip there. This is the three-finger grip versus the full four-finger grip. It's a nice thumb ramp right there. So, honestly, between the two that I've tested, I would have to say I'd go with the bird flight with the G10 handle. So.